1 second.
I repeatedly said that both in the terrorist cases, and Mr. I challenge Mr. you Jethmalani, to sue
I can
me for
also name
me.
You in several other things.
You can. You're free to.
Jethmalani, I think stop being
but
personal.
But I welcome a defamation suit from you.
We know what exactly you are.
I think Arnav, you should stop this personal attacks.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, the Congress comes out in the defense.
Really?
Mr. Jayanarayan Vyas wanted to come in. Vinod Mehta, thank you for your patience. I'm just coming to you in a minute. Yes, Jayanarayan Vyas.
Arnab, I hope and pray that you will manage the house in such a manner that I'll have an uninterrupted
Yes, sir, I will.
You know what seems to be a thing in my friend, learned friend, Mr. Mukul Sinha, seems to be proceeding on a premise that the lower court has no judicial mind and whatever is decided by the lower court and which is appealable in the higher courts is
Absolute
not a kind of a justice done, and it still Modi should be considered as guilty because there is an appellate court.
Yeah.
He is forgetting the preliminary principle of the jurisprudence that in the eyes of the law a person is innocent unless he is held guilty. So please don't make this argument often again. It is not valid as far as the jurisprudence is concerned, as far as the law is concerned. Coming to the second point, what is your intention? What is your premise? You will stop only when you feel that Mr. Modi is Christian guilty. I think these wishes are never going to be fulfilled. And third, let me tell you, Mr. Mukul Sinha, that you are saying why he is speaking after 12 years. Up for almost these years, you were every day trying to have a pot shot at him, and if you would have come out and said anything, you would have simply said that these are crocodile's tears. You go to SIT or you go to the appellate court and you say whatever you want to say there. This is not the way to air your grievances. So you are like that absolutely, it is a seesaw affair where you go this
are
way, you cut it, you come back, you are cutting it. You don't have the stance, you don't have the stand, you don't have the argument. The fact of life is that a person has suffered a virulent vilification campaign for 12 years and he has every right to speak, and Mr. Modi has spoken. What is the problem with you? Why don't you uphold his personal right? Why don't you uphold his personal freedom? As an individual, as a citizen of this country, even he has this right, and this right has to be respected. So what is the problem with you?
Well, I think
I don't understand, Mr.
I come back to that point.
Absolutely baseless.
I do not have any problem with him. The people of Gujarat and the people of India believe he
Mukul,
is
then why are you unnecessarily making points? Why are you making issues which are not relevant? These are absolutely irrelevant issues.
Can we go back to the politics and
this
not stray into a legal
you
debate?
Your vision is tainted.
Can I?
You are suffering from Modi phobia and you have only one objective in mind, like Gerard Ford, that any color is good so far, so it is black. Justice
now,
will only be done if Modi is held guilty. Is
so,
this the premise on which a lawyer can
Mr. Mehta,
which a legal case can be
Mr. Mehta, are you part of the anti-Modi brigade? And if you are, then is an apology the one-point agenda of the anti-Modi brigade?
Arnav, I can't be part of the anti-Modi brigade because in your studio, I announced that Mr. Modi would be the next Prime Minister of India. So, I mean, the question is that this is the first time that Mr. Modi has directly addressed the question of 2002 riots.
Yeah.
He's done it in a blog, but this is the first time he's done it. Now, I haven't read the full blog, but the little excerpts I have read, this is mostly about Mr. Modi's private suffering.
What?
The blog is about how Mr. Modi privately suffered, how much anguish he had, how much he had sleepless nights, etc., etc. Now, I think he said absolutely nothing about the people who didn't suffer privately.
That's not
and
true. That's not true.
Is completely
That's not true, Mr. Mehta.
It is part of self. Arnab, please let me finish. Please let me finish. Let me finish, Arnab. Please let me finish.
He has already made a mention about it.
It is part of self-vindication to say that I was into. One other point. Even if Mr. Modi has been legally cleared, even if all the courts of India have said that Mr. Modi had no direct role in the riots. He was at least the chief minister of the state. The riots happened on his watch. The least I expect from him is to take My constructive goodness. Responsibility
terrible,
for the riots
argument.
And express regret and apologize to the people and to say that I was the chief minister and it happened during my time and I am extremely
But
sorry
Mr. Mehta,
before you
how many chief ministers have done it, Mr. Mehta, in your
Dr.
long and distinguished
Singh
career? Can you tell me how many chief ministers have done that?
And apologize
Arnab, I would like to know from Mr. Mehta, that the distinguished journalist and a veteran journalist he is, how many chief ministers in this country have done this? Riots have, much worse riots have taken place. How many chief ministers have done this? Tell me one example.
What is it?
How many chief ministers have apologized for riots?
Mr. Mehta, I'm asking
Has Akhilesh apologized for Muzaffarnagar?
Dr. Manmohan Singh apologized for the riots in the Golden Temple. Sonia Gandhi has apologized for
Sonia Gandhi has not apologized. Sonia Gandhi has not apologized. Sonia Gandhi, no, Vinod Mehta. Vinod Mehta, I cross swords with you right now on that. Vinod Mehta, Sonia Gandhi has not apologized. Has she apologized, Mahesh Jethmalani? Has she apologized, Pawan Verma?
Sonia Gandhi has not apologized for the Sikh riot. Let me tell you something. There has been no apology for 29 years about the Sikh riots from anybody.
Yes.
Nobody has condemned in the Congress party Rajiv Gandhi's infamous statement that when a big tree falls, the earth shakes. Not one congressman has had the courage
to
condemn that statement.
Dr. Manmohan Singh went to the Golden Temple. Darbar Sahib, he apologized.
No. We talk about Sonia Gandhi.
The Prime Minister of India apologized in Darbar Sahib.
But this is for all together.
This is a matter of record.
Mr. Vinod Mehta, your partisan colors are showing. Mr. Manmohan Singh went about 20 years later to the Golden Temple. 20 years later. And B, your partisan colors are showing.
Yes,
why don't you
true.
Speak with
very
the same fervor about the riots in Assam that just took place and condemn and ask Mr. Tarun Gogoi to give an apology?
Did Tarun Gogoi apologize for the...
Tarun Gogoi apologize?
I asked that question. One second. Let's ask the Congress and Pawan Verma 1 minute. Did Tarun Gogoi apologize for the ethnic violence in Assam and take responsibility and say, I will resign? Did Akhilesh take responsibility and say, I'll resign for Muzaffarnagar? Did, with respect, Naveen Patnaik say after Kandamal that I'm sorry, Ami Agnik, Sonia Gandhi only expressed anguish at the anti-Sikh riots. So Narendra Modi also has expressed anguish. But when Sonia Gandhi expresses anguish, Ami Agnik, you go out there and start applauding and you say, what a wonderful thing Sonia Gandhi has done. But when Narendra Modi expresses anguish, then both you and Pawan Verma say, not good enough. That's a bit hypocritical, isn't it, Ms. Yagnik and Mr. Yes, Ms. Yagnik.
There is no hypocrisy
allow me,
here.
Allow me.
There is no hypocrisy here.
Yeah.
Can I please complete?
Yeah. Go ahead.
This is a unique case. Yeah,
what
this
unique?
This is a unique case where the chief minister was right there. And
really?
There is liability of the chief minister.
And who was chief minister?
Right, and there is no question of apology.
No, and I want to ask you.
No such word
I want to ask you.
It is just talking about anguish.
I want
he
to ask you.
He is talking about his personal grief. There is no question of any apology. And whatever happens in the highest court regarding this matter.
I think that's, I think it's, I think Ami Agnik.
There are 2 lakh people were displaced.
No, Ami Agnik.
It's going to remain a blur.
Ami Agnik.
The history of
Ami Agnik, Ami Agnik, you know what? After Operation Blue Star, January of 1998, Pawan Verma will remember. January of 1998, Sonia Gandhi says, Jo kuch 6 June ko hua tha, uska mujhe dukh hua. In other words, I'm anguished by the events of January 6th. On the riots, She said she could understand the pain of the Sikhs as she herself had experienced it, losing her husband Rajiv and mother-in-law Indira Gandhi that way. And then she said, quote, "There is no use recalling what we have collectively lost." These are her words, Pawan Verma. "There is no use recalling what we have collectively lost. No words, no words can balm that pain." Now, how are you looking for words like regret and remorse? And how, Pawan Verma, therefore, is it that you don't apply the same index to the Congress party just because you won the Bihar package from them before the general elections, that you apply to Narendra Modi?
I think you are also, Arnav, you are also being too cynical.
Arnav, cynical.
Simple, let me state it simply. One wrong does not justify another
Arnav,
wrong.
There is a dialogue.
Arnav, one second, Arnav. I did not interrupt Mr. Vyas. The fact that the Sikhs riots against the Sikhs took place after Indira Gandhi's death, it scarred the nation. The fact how the Congress behaved then, it's not about saying they were worse than us. We have in front of us an attempt by a person who has a claim to be the Prime Minister of this country in terms of what his party wants him to be. We have to judge whether that blog written today carries credibility
So you're saying Pawan Verma.
I'm not saying for a moment that what the Congress
you are saying,
right.
Pawan Verma. No, Mr. Verma, I'm sorry. Sir. What you are saying is, don't ask about Akhilesh, don't ask about Naveen Patnaik, don't even ask about Sonia Gandhi, because they are not trying to be Prime Minister. But because Narendra Modi is trying to be Prime Minister, he must apologize. He must express regret. He must express remorse.
Arnab, please understand.
Very right.
Arnab, I am not for a moment holding a candle or a brief for those who could have behaved far better in situations of a similar kind. I am just making the point that today, frankly, I would like to give the benefit of doubt to Mr. Modi, but I think this is an issue of credibility.
No, okay.
The timing and its content, the way it has come, after 12 years of denial, and at a time when action and deed would have mattered there was silence.
How many years was the Congress Party silent, and how long is the Congress Party silent on 1984?
I'm not saying that is right. Please try
to but the same.
I'm not saying that.
A response.
I am saying
Welcoming into the debate, Tista Setalwar. It is Vinod Mehta's turn to come in. Vinod Mehta.
They were silent. But when the investigation reports indicted them,
I want to say something, Arnav.
When they were absolutely
done. Can I say something?
Then Vinod, come out and
Jainaran Vyas,
spoken about Arnav. This whatever apology you are
Jainaran Vyas, Vinod Mehta, who has faced full frontal attack from your colleague Mahesh Jethmalani, saying his colors are showing, etc., needs to intervene, and I allow Mr. Vinod Mehta the intervention. After that, Tista Setalwad will face the next question.
Please go ahead.
Vinod Mehta.
Arnav, I just want to ask one simple question.
Yeah.
It is more than likely that Mr. Narendra Modi is going to be the next Prime Minister of India.
Yeah.
He has already moved a step forward by this blog, by at least addressing the question. The issue is that whatever the legal kind of, all the legal escapes that Mr. Modi may have, the question is, he was chief minister when the riots happened. How much of a leap of faith and how big is the problem of going from this blog to the next one to simply say, listen, I was chief minister, I had nothing to do with the riots, I tried to
control them. He's never said that.
But they still happened on my watch.
Why would you want him to say something?
I apologize to you.
No. Well, why would you want, we wouldn't say that.
I wanted to say that.
But he wouldn't say that, Mr. Mehta.
Arnab.
He's never said I'm
loyal. I have a question for Mr. Vinod Mehta.
Okay.
Arnab, I wanted to just ask Vinod ji, that why is, I mean, what is, what is the reason the for your special love and affection for Mr. Modi when nobody in this country has done this, who is not guilty, even when the person was guilty? Why you want Mr. Modi to apologize? The moment he apologizes, you will have another argument.
Exactly.
That he was guilty and therefore guilty conscience bites and he has apologized.
At least express some regret.
So what is the reason for your special love and affection for Mr. Modi? How, why you want to single him out for this special treatment?
Arnav, if you read the blog carefully, the blog unambiguously is an implicit and tacit admission that something went wrong on his watch, which he could not control, and he has deep personal anguish and regret for it. But if there are doubting thoughts,
apologize.
If there are doubting thoughts,
I want to get Teesta to respond to you.